Violence erupted on the 26th November 2016 in the town of Kasese when the Uganda Police Force and the UPDF jointly raided the government offices of the Rwenzururu Kingdom, killing Rwenzururu Royal Guards and arresting the King Wesley Mumbere and some of his guards. Parliament directed Defence and Internal Affairs Committee to investigate the attack. Unfortunately, the report has never been released. Amriet asked Speaker Rebecca Kadaga to direct the House to discuss the report.
There is unfinished business. And this business includes what needs to be done after the massacre of many people. Today, we do not even know how many people are unaccounted for. And so our call as the FDC to the authorities is for them not to continue being mute about this, but to tell us exactly what happened in Kasese and to give a clear account of the lives that were lost in Kasese.
After the raid at the palace of Mumbere, leaders in Kasese, including the leader of opposition Winnie Kiza, petitioned Parliament and the International Criminal Court for an independent probe. Amriat stressed that if the committee reports the truth, it will help them press government to offer an explanation.
Well, in terms of trust, the committee has no option but to speak the truth. Because what played out in Kasese was there laid bare for not only the people of Kasese to see, but also the entire world to see. And so all we expect is really the truth put on record.
Close to 2 years now after Kasese district was plunged into a conflict which claimed hundreds of lives, the widows and orphans left behind are still struggling to make a living. Over the week, government, through Operation Wealth Creation, handed over 100 pigs to residents who lost their relatives in the raid. Mubarak Mugabo, Urban Television.